Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it. Sing out. Let it rain. Let it rain.
We bless the name of the Lord for to read that you have been of the open heaven. You are welcome. And I pray that the Lord will bless you again in Jesus' name. Let us have a short prayer. Father, Lord, we thank you for today. We thank you for another edition of the Open Heaven. We ask you to bless the viewer and bless us too in the name of Jesus Christ. We ask that the topic of today will transform the life of the era in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, because you have answered. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. The topic of today is the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. That is a wonderful name. It's a beautiful name. And so we'll be looking at the name of Jesus. Our memory verse is taken from the book of Philippians, chapter 2, verse 9. Say, wherefore God has highly exalted him and given him a name that is above every other name. That's the name of Jesus. Philippians 2, 9 to 11 is our Bible reading. Philippians 2, 9 to 11. It says, wherefore God has highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every name should bow, of things in heaven and of things in earth and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Praise the Lord. What an authority. What an authority. That every tongue confess. That every knee must bow. Before we go into our main, the body of today's open heaven, as written by our Father in the Lord, I want to tell you that the name of Jesus is the most powerful and the potent name on earth. And I want you to follow me as we read the body, because you will see the power in the name of Jesus, and this name will transform your life. Let's go on to the body. Say, oh, I love the name of Jesus. That's our Father in the Lord saying. Oh, I love the name of Jesus. It is the most powerful name in all the universe. Can you hear that? It is the most powerful name in all the universe. Is that I recall the story of a young man called Samuel who gave his life to Jesus Christ while his mother was the leader of idol worshippers in their village. Samuel was filled with a zeal to win his mother and the village for Christ. So he decided to start off by burning all the idols and the charms in their houses. His mother was furious at his action, so she invited the members of a secret society to kill her son, as she would not be able to kill him by himself. That's the story of a young man that gave his life to Jesus Christ, filled with a passion for the Lord, and he decided to win his mother and the whole village. But because he came from a background of an idol worshiper, he started, just like Gideon, to burn down the idol of their family. and the village idol. So the mother was so furious, invited all the secret society to kill the boy. Well, let's see whether they succeeded in killing Samuel. The mother ensured the boy was alone in the house. Around midnight, Samuel knelt to pray after having shut all windows and doors. It was then a huge dog with charms tied all over its body came in through the locked door and headed straight for him. There was no time to pray. However, there was enough time to shout, "Jesus." Can I hear you shout that name? Jesus. There was time to shout, "Jesus." Something like a thunderbolt came into the room, through the walls, and struck the dog dead on the spot. Can you see what happened? This secret court, they sent a demon that appeared in form of a dog onto Samuel. There was no time to pray at that time, but Samuel, filled with the power of God, shouted, "Jesus!" And the thunderbolt came in and struck the dog dead. That dog came in through the closed door. That means it was not an ordinary dog. It was a demon, because demons cannot be stopped by physical structures. Likewise, the power of God can move through any medium. So when he shouted the name above all names, Jesus Christ, the thunderbolt came in and killed the dog. That's a victory. Through the name of Jesus Christ. You can have victory through that name. Anytime, any day, any hours, I've seen deliverance through the name of Jesus. And I know the name of Jesus can save and can deliver. And it can give you victory over your adversaries. Let's go on to read Philippians 2:10. That at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow of things in heaven and of things on earth and things under the earth. The phrase "things in heaven, on earth, and under the earth" already covers everything possible. That phrase, that every knee must bow, whether things in heaven, on earth, covers everything. Whether physical, whether invisible, whether visible, it covers it. The name of Jesus is an authority above every other name. This means that nothing can withstand or resist the name of Jesus. There is no problem, demon, or situation that will not bow once they hear the name of Jesus. This is why our mouth must always call on the name of Jesus. I love this song. It says, "Jesus is the sweetest name I know. Oh, he's always just the same. Oh, praise his holy name. That is the reason why I love him so. I say, Jesus is the sweetest name I know." That's the sweetest name. That's why I too, like our Father in the Lord, love the name of Jesus. Calling that name, I've seen great victory in the name of Jesus. We must note, however, that the name of Jesus is only potent in the mouth of his children. It says in Isaiah 59, verse 1 to 2, "Behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened that he cannot save, neither is ear heavy that he cannot hear. But your iniquity has separated between you and your God, and your sin have hid his face from you, that he will not hear you. The name of Jesus is powerful, but is only potent in the hands of his children, in the mouth of his children. In the life of a sinner, the name of Jesus will not do anything, though it's powerful, though it's effective. That is why you need to give your life to Jesus if you want to see the power in the name of Jesus. No matter how loud you shout the name of Jesus, if you are a sinner, if you are not born again, everyone that is not born again is a sinner. He will not even hear, not to talk of as answering. If you want the name of Jesus to work for you, you must accept him into your life as your Lord and Savior. Then stay away from sin. If you want the name of Jesus to work for you, you must accept him as your Lord and Savior. Then stay away from sin. Live righteously through the grace that you have in Christ Jesus. The name of Jesus can save you. The name of Jesus can set you free. The name of Jesus can deliver you. Whether you're having a nightmare, call on that name. It will deliver you. Whether you're having a challenge or anything that is troubling you, call on that name. It's going to answer for you. Call on the name of Jesus and you will see great deliverance. You will see healing. You will see way where there seems to be no way. The name of Jesus is the potent power that can set you free and that can help you to fulfill your dreams and aspirations. I want to believe that you will begin to call on that name. And for you watching who has not given your life to Christ, give your life to Christ. Say, Jesus, come into my life. Sanctify me through your blood and let your name be potent in my mouth. Write my name in the book of life and you'll be saved and you will see the wonder working power in the name of Jesus Christ. Our reflection is, if you call the name of Jesus now, would he answer? That's a question for you. If the answer is no, then make amends immediately and give your life to Jesus. And I've led you in what to say, that you should just accept him by calling him into your life. You can sing this hymn, and I believe the Spirit of God will visit you. Hymn 11, In Our Open Heaven, I am so glad that our Father in heaven. It's also a wonderful, wonderful hymn about Jesus Christ. God bless you. From today, begin to call on the name of Jesus. In the day, in the night, when you are sleeping, when you are awake, when you are traveling, call on that name and you will see miracle. God bless you. Let us pray. Father, Lord, we thank you for what you have done for us. You saved us. You redeemed us with your precious blood. And you did not only leave us without power. You filled us with the Holy Ghost and gave us the name that is above every other name. The name of Jesus Christ. And through that name, we are assured of victory, great and mighty deliverance, and successes. Thank you for what you have done for us. Thank you for the name of Jesus. Thank you for those who have accepted Jesus through this program. Thank you because as they call on your name, you will empower the name of Jesus in their mouth, and it shall be well with them. Thank you, Father Lord. We give you all the glory. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Call on that name. God bless you.
Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it. Sing out.